Tonight, four of our groups are taking on your favorite chart-topping hits as they compete for the Sony recording contract and the $100,000. Kicking it off is a group that set the stage on fire last time with a performance that got very hot in here. Let's see how the Soulful Singers of 10 prepared for a number one track from the one and only Queen of Soul.
Our number one song is Chain of Fools by Aretha Franklin.
Chain of Fools.
The judges loved our last performance.
You guys have so much power. Once y'all, like, tap into it, y'all gonna blow the roof off of this mic, man. I'm trying to tell you. I'm waiting to hear y'all take us all to church. I'm waiting.
The judges expect more from us. We all come from a strong church background, so we know what they mean by taking it to church.
10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10.
Sean Stockman took time out to stop by and give us some tips and some pointers.
Stop. Okay. Drag it out. Like, make it gritty and grimy. Just those little things that, you know, make you go, ugh.
It is awesome that Sean's becoming like a mentor type to us. We all look up to him.
I want people to be like this. The stank face.
The stank face. It's like, you know, you just don't know what else to do. There are no words. You just, it's all in your face. So we're gonna make him make the stank face.
Make people feel you. Take them to church.
Y'all ready to take them to church?
Yeah. I said, are you ready to take them to church?
Yeah. I said, are you ready?
The sing-off has insurance because we're about to blow the roof off the place.
5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10!
Performing Chain of Fools by Aretha Franklin, here is 10.
1, 2, 3, chain, chain, chain.
Is this good stank face, Sean?
Oh, yeah, that's good. That's good.
Ooh, stanky up here. Oh. All right, Sean. You said you wanted to be taken to church. That has got to qualify.
Here's the thing that sucked about that whole performance. It wasn't long enough. Like, first of all, it was great. It was that's exactly what I was talking about. You know what I mean? The power that you guys show. Like, the way you gave Dee Dee the stage to do her thing. Oh, the grit in your voice. Oh! That performance right there is your signature as far as who you are. When people say 10, I guarantee they will bring up this performance right here. That's what it's all about. Great job. Great job.
All right, Jewel, tell us about 10. What'd you think?
I want to go to that church. That was fun. Dee Dee, you did a great job. It was just beautiful. You know, it was an understated vocal, and, you know, if I had pipes like yours, I'd be, like, singing way too much all over the place, showing off, going, did you see that? Did you check that out? Girls backing her up, Imani, Peaches, and Sydney, that sounded great. Y'all just supported her. You gave her a place to grow and be there. You guys back there in the band, acting like a band, it was, I loved it. I loved the staging. It was great.
Awesome. All right, Ben.
I love the space that you created at the top. I love the fact that your group of 10 singers, and now you're starting to sound like a band, which is awesome. I think the only place in the rhythm section is a very difficult thing to do. That gospel, that thing for a band, like, you know, as a drummer, bass player, and pianist myself, I always find that a difficult thing to support because it can sound like a polka. The singers were on top of it, killing. The band underneath, I don't think you quite supported that part. That was one place I'd like to see come up, but it was amazing. Every week you guys are just, I mean, you're dangerous.
Thank you, Ten. Great start. Remember, you can download any of the songs you hear tonight on iTunes. When we come back, more stellar vocal groups light up the stage with chart-topping singles.
I've got some news for you. I've got some news for you.
It's all leading up to tonight's ultimate sing-off, where two groups duke it out for a spot in the next round. Sing-off, keep it tuned.
I don't know what she did with her voice.
Got tired. It's awesome.
Yes. That tired.
She was just, and it came out easy. That's another thing about Aretha is that she wasn't forcing that tone. Mm-mm. It was just her tone. It came out of her head that way, you know?